Rev up your engine! Welcome to a special Scotty Kilmer video. Look, you get to see me without my sunglasses on, but that's not the point of the video. The point of the video is YouTube has been very good to me. I've been very fortunate. This is my son's flight helmet when he was in 101st Airborne, and I know what it's like to be in an Army family. I'm gonna help out all the men and women down the street at Fort Campbell here. I'm getting settled down here in Clarksville, getting my garage all ready, and I'm gonna check out soldiers' wives' cars for free. I know what it's like to have loved ones far away. Say, it's a married couple, and the husband's overseas, the wife's stuck here. I'll help them all out with their car problems. Got a serious problem, need to know what's wrong, or say they're buying a used car. I can give you a hand free to tell you, is it a good car to buy, a bad car to buy, or maybe you've been quoted an extremely high repair bill on something. I can tell you, does it really need that? Could you do it cheaper? Is there another way around it? As you can see with my ThinkTool scope box, I've got freeze frame analysis equipment. I've been working on cars for the last 53 years, so I'll share all this knowledge to all soldiers and your wives, or soldiers and your husbands. It goes both ways. And if it is soldiers and your wives, don't worry about me stealing your wife away while you're deployed. I've been married for 42 years to the same woman, and anyways, I'm old. I'm not gonna attract any young women anymore anyway. I'm beyond that stage of my life. Now, I haven't quite left my motorcycle stage yet, but that's another story. But even if you're planning on buying a motorcycle like a lot of soldiers do, realize these OBD tools, they plug into modern motorcycles too. I can check out motorcycles before you buy them to see if they're still a good deal or not. I've been a biker since I was a teenager, so motorcycles, bring them on too. I can check them out. Give you some straight up thoughts on good versus bad. Maybe somebody told you need to do a whole bunch of maintenance that doesn't need to be done. I'll tell you the truth. I have no vested interest here other than helping everybody out. We gave my son a lot of support when he did 2 tours in Afghanistan. That was his service. Now my service is, I can help all you guys out here in the Fort Campbell area, free. Because there's nothing worse than being ripped off. Just the other day here, had a soldier bring me a vehicle he had bought from one of these used car lots. He'd paid $8,000 for a vehicle that was worth maybe 3 with these outrageous payments. If he would have come to me in the first place, I would have said, don't buy it at that price, it's outrageous. The car itself was okay, but he way overpaid for it. I understand this stuff. You don't want to get a bad vehicle that doesn't run right, but you don't want to pay too much for it either. And let's say you're deployed and your wife or husband's back here in Clarksville. They've got a problem with their car and they're worried they have to spend a small fortune on it. I can check them out for free. Figure out what's wrong. Tell you the right thing to do. Sometimes I have to tell the truth and say, look, you're going to have to put more money in this vehicle than it's worth. Go find another used vehicle. Forget this. Or I've seen it where shops told them they needed $2,000 worth of work, and I saw all they needed was a couple hundred dollars worth of work in the real world. Unfortunately, cars have gotten more and more complex as days gone on. In my grandfather's day, it wasn't that hard to check out a good used car. Today, different story entirely. But with the complexity of modern cars, you need things like this to really check them out well. These days, you need to fight computers with computers. Everybody whines about, oh, these cars are so complicated, oh, they're so hard to fix. Sometimes that's true. But the reverse is also true. You're looking at a used car. Computer systems I have, when I plug them in, within 10, 15 minutes, I can give you a really good idea what shape the thing is. I can see, oh, the cams are worn. Don't buy it. Or, hey, this is in immaculate shape. I've seen people buy Toyotas that had 380,000 miles that were in immaculate shape. On the other hand, I've seen people buy Chryslers that had 60,000 miles on them that were falling apart. And the electrical analysis with all this equipment doesn't take all that long to make a decision one way or the other. But of course, most people don't have the money or the time or the inclination to learn all that stuff. So find a guy like me to tell you the truth. And if you're in the Fort Campbell area, in the Army, retired Army, whatever, feel free to contact me to set up an appointment to check your stuff out for free. Hey, you guys are serving the country. The least I can do is help you and your family out here. I'm living here. I love Tennessee. I have like a new lease on life, and I want to share all my information to help other people out. Now, unfortunately, you're going to have to be in the Fort Campbell, Clarksville area of Tennessee, where I happen to be now. well, but I plan on being here for quite some time. I like helping people out, and I hate it when people get ripped off. No, sometimes people get ripped off because they choose the wrong vehicle. I'll warn people about that. Sometimes they choose the right vehicle, but it was wrecked, flooded, or stolen. Sometimes they have the right vehicle, but the wrong mechanic was trying to sell them stuff they don't need. I've seen that over the years in Houston. I've seen people that have spent $10,000 over a 5-year period having a car repaired, and I find out that some of the stuff wasn't even done. A lot of it wasn't necessary. I want to keep that from happening to people as much as I can. And you know that old saying, you can't get something for nothing? Well, in this case, you can. I'm giving away all my information totally free to soldiers and all their dependents at Fort Campbell. These guys are putting their life on the line. The least I can do is take some of my knowledge and tools and help you guys and gals out. And I do have an ulterior motive. It helps me out too, because like my wife said, nothing's worse than a man with nothing to do. If I don't have anything to do, who knows what's going to happen to me? My grandfather, when he retired, because my father shut down the corner Texaco gas station, he was dead within a year. He wasn't doing anything. He just whittled away and he was gone within a year. I plan on sticking around as long as my old Celica, maybe even longer. So contact me if you're at Fort Campbell. So now comes the $1 million question. How do you get a hold of me? Or, it's really complicated. Just email me, scottykilmer@gmail.com. It can't get any simpler than that. Now, of course, I get lots of emails. On your email, just put a title. Say, Fort Campbell Soldier Seeking Help. That's all you gotta put down there. And I will read every single one of those. Now, please don't pretend to be a soldier when you aren't. These guys are putting their lives on the line, so don't play games. I know it happens in the internet. There's a lot of lunatics out there. Don't waste mine and the soldiers' time by pretending to be something you aren't. A lot of soldiers here. There's over 22,000 soldiers here and over 40,000 of their dependents. I'm assuming you guys are gonna keep me busy for quite some time, and that'll make me a happy man. It'll also make my wife happy, because then she gets a break from me for a while. So whether it's cars, trucks, vans, or motorcycles, old school or new school screaming racer bikes, if you're stationed here at Fort Campbell and need a little transportation help, just send me an email. Like I said, scottykilmer@gmail.com. It doesn't get any simpler than that. Because now that I'm almost all set up here in Tennessee, I'm just waiting and raring to go. And if any of you in 101st Airborne have a little bit of pull, I'd love to go out on a jump with you guys someday. And if I could wheedle a ride in an Abrams tank, that would make a very interesting video. I'd love to do that too. I'm here to help out all the soldiers at Fort Campbell. Don't be shy, step right up. Scotty will lend you a hand and keep you from getting ripped off. Because everybody knows the soldiers don't get paid all that much, and every penny counts with the soldier. So if I can help them save their pennies, I'm all for it. Free checkouts, helping them out with their car problems. It'd be an honor for me to do it. Oh, and before I forget, if anybody there can give me some nice helicopter rides around, I'd really enjoy that. I haven't been in a helicopter for 4 or 5 years, and I really enjoy flying around in helicopters. So start sending those email requests in. All you men and women in the armed forces deserve a little break now and then, and I'm here to give it to you. And here's some bonus questions and answers. The club says, I just changed my pads and rotors. Now the car pulls to the left when I brake. I did take the calipers off, but I didn't see any fluid leaking on them. What should I do to test it? If it pulls to the left only when you brake, you're probably going to need a new front left caliper. Now, most guys would replace them in pairs, but what the heck, it's your money. And if you replace the left caliper and it stops pulling, great. You might find that if you replace that, then it pulls to the right, then you'd have to replace the right one. And you can get rebuilt ones at auto parts stores. It's cheap enough on most vehicles. See how your car goes straight without braking. And if it slightly pulls to the left, when you hit the brakes, it's going to pull more. And since you changed the brakes and rotors, the brakes work better than they used to, right? If you have a slight alignment problem with the new brakes and new rotors, then it's going to pull to that side more, even though it's not the actual brake system, but it is something with the alignment. Something's worn in the front end, so it pulls to that side, and when you brake, it pulls it more. So check to see if it pulls without braking. If it doesn't pull at all without braking, then change the left front caliper first and see what happens. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.